Hey guys, it's Xiao. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I wanted to share with you guys how I store all of my stationery items. But before we get into the video, I wanted to mention my lighting. If you guys don't follow me on my Instagram, I posted a picture of my new studio lights that I'm super excited about because I finally decided to invest in some studio lights. So I purchased the Limo Studio 700 watt softbox lights off of Amazon for about $75. So they were pretty affordable. I'm really excited about these lights because I only really used to be able to record on the weekends because I worked Monday through Friday, and then when I got home around 4 p.m. the sun already started to set, so lighting wasn't really good. That's why I haven't been able to produce a lot of videos for you guys, but now that I have these lights, I can film whenever I want to. So I'm really excited that I can produce better quality videos for you guys. So if you guys are not a subscriber yet, please go ahead and press the subscribe button if you'd like to see more videos from me. I will go ahead and link these studio lights down below if you guys are interested. But enough about the studio lights. If you guys want to see how I store all of my stationery items, then definitely just keep watching.
Alright, so this is a drawer unit that I use to store all of my stationery items. This is from IKEA, but I actually purchased it off of Craigslist, so I really recommend checking out Craigslist if you're looking to purchase a lot of IKEA things for a reduced price. But this is just what it looks like. It is their 6 drawer unit. I think this one is actually for jewelry because that top shelf here actually opens up into a mirror, but I just have a place down so I can store stuff on top. So the two first drawer are skinnier, so I store a lot of my washi tapes and just smaller tools. And then this third drawer, which is a lot deeper, I store most of my sticky notes and notepads. And then this fourth drawer, I store a lot of my big ideas items and miscellaneous inserts and stuff like that. These two last drawers are not really stationery related. That second to the bottom one is just some makeup, and then the last one is just miscellaneous things, so I would not be showing that one. But yeah, this is pretty much what it looks like, and I love it. Super sturdy, and the drawers come out really, really well. So let's go ahead and look inside all of the drawers.
Alright, so starting off with this top drawer. This drawer is a little messy and just random. I have a lot of my paper clips in here, some of my DIY paper clips that I made, which I will link the video down below if you guys want to see that. In the back here, I have some empty containers that I like to keep and reuse if I find a use for it. So these be my big ideas containers, and then again, random paper clips, more paper clips. You know, nothing super exciting. Alright, and then moving on to the second drawer, which is my favorite. This is my washi tape drawer. So this is just what it looks like. I have them all organized and squeezed together so they don't roll all over the place. I do have some in the back here. These are smaller and these are about to run out, so I just kind of let them roll around back there. But I try to keep them organized by the packs that I buy them in. So these are set, these come in a set, these come in a set. So if you guys saw my previous haul, you guys know what I'm talking about. But I like to keep them together because I like to keep all the color schemes together, and then this came in a big set too, so I don't really color coordinate. But up in the front here, I like to keep a lot of my gold foiled because I love gold foiled. A lot of these are gold foiled. I just bought these new ones from Hobby Lobby, so this one is a whole set as well. So I like to keep all of that together. All of my washi tapes I either bought from Michaels, Hobby Lobby, or Joann's, or Target. So those are the main four stores I get them from. Alright, onto the third drawer. This drawer is a lot deeper, so I can put a lot more stuff. So I put a lot of my sticky notes, page flags, and stamping stuff in this area. So starting off in this little bucket, I got all of these buckets from Walmart. They're super cheap. They come in like packs of 2 or 3 for like $2 to $3. So this big one, I keep a lot of the longer sticky notes, or excuse me, a lot of the longer notepads that I get from Target. I don't have as many things anymore just because I sold a lot of them. And then I have some individual sticky notes, again from Target, because they're super popular. And then this little section, I just have individual ones that aren't in packets anymore. The back here, I just have some random sticky notes, again from Target. And then this section is more sticky notes, of course. Can't have too many sticky notes. A lot of these are from Target. I got some from Tuesday Morning, and then more from Target back here. These are more like page flags. Like I stated, I don't have a lot anymore. I don't have many of the old unicorn ones anymore because I sold them, but I do have a couple. And then in this section here, I have a lot of my stamping stuff. So I have my individual stamping pens that I got from Michaels, and then just some stamping sets from like Target and stuff. And then I do have my stamping alphabets here. This one is a number one, and then this one is a caps, and then this one has a box, which I love these. I was searching forever for like number ones, but I actually don't stamp a lot. I don't think I've ever used these, to be honest, but they're really cute and I like to have them because they're super cheap. They're like $3 each. So that is it for this drawer here. Alright, and moving on to this last drawer, these two bottom ones, this one is just makeup and that one is a miscellaneous stuff, so I'm just going to show you this one. This one has a lot of the Happy Planner stuff, so in this little baggie here, I keep my Etsy stickers that I use, so I just keep them all here. And then in this section, I have a lot of some of the Happy Planner packets, like this is a calendar extension packet. And then these are some of the inserts for my 2017. I like to take some of it out so that my Happy Planner isn't too full. So once it hits May, I'm gonna put these inserts back into my Happy Planner. And then this is my old Happy Planner here. Very well loved. Great memories in here. And then these are just really random things. Some older Happy Planner inserts, like folders and stuff. And then down here is some Doki planner inserts. I used to have a Doki book, so that's that. And then on the side here are a lot of my Happy Planner sticker booklets. As you guys can see here, I have some stickers from Michaels, and then like I stated, a lot of my Happy Planner sticker booklets. I don't have too many, but I love these because they're a really good price if you get them on sale and you get so many stickers. So definitely go ahead and check those out. And then over here are just sticker books. And then I have some of my sticky note packets. I have this one from Target, which is adorable. I haven't really used it. This one I bought from like TJ Maxx a long time ago, but so cute. And then this random one, I don't know why I bought it, but I don't even use it. And then this one, which I also really like as well. And then a random one from Target here. And then also on the side here, I have some of these alphabet stickers from Target long time ago. And then some, just some random stickers from like Hobby Lobby. So these are longer, so I like to keep them on the side here so that they don't get bent and stuff. And then in this little container here are just, again, random sticker packets. I have some here that I clip together. So these are alphabet stickers from like Target and Hobby Lobby and Michaels and stuff like that. And then again, random stickers. And then I have some of the original Happy Planner disc. I bought some from Etsy, and then I bought these skinnier ones, or these smaller ones, because I thought I needed them, but I didn't. And then on the side here is just some Christmas tags, some note cards from Target if I ever need them, and then just some cardstock packets that I bought and I occasionally use. Alright, and then like I stated, this last one here is just some of my makeup that I don't touch as often. And then down here is miscellaneous things that I'm not going to show you guys because it's not super important. Alright, so that is it for my video. I hope you guys all enjoyed. If you guys have any questions, feel free to let me know down below. Again, if you guys are new to my channel, please press that subscribe button if you'd like to see more videos from me. But thank you guys so much for watching.